Story time with Thulz. Hello, my friends. Hello, my family. Hello, everybody. Welcome to my channel. My name is Thulz, and welcome to Story Time with Thulz. Yes. So guys, today I'm gonna be telling you a story that actually happened very recently. And yeah, so basically what happened is, okay, just hold on guys, so I forgot a braid when I was tying my hair and it was bothering me. Okay, I'm good. Okay, so what happened guys is, it was about 2 weeks ago. So I was basically, okay, the week before I was like online looking for a job, applying like for learnerships, jobs and stuff. And so I get this like a post that basically said that like there's like learnerships for like air hostesses, cabin crews, travel like bartenders and travel waitresses. It was a pretty like broad like learnership. There was even like IT systems and stuff. It was very like broad, right? And so basically I thought like, oh, it's pretty good. I mean, at least I can choose what I want to do, you know. I'm not like limited to only what like the learnership offers. It's like a variety of things. So I was very excited and I was keen. I was like, oh my god, okay, let me just apply for this and I hope it's actually, you know, a good turnout. So great, I apply, I send in my CV and everything. And then a week later I get an email, right? And this email is basically, so the first email I got was from apprentice@JD World Staffing, right? And this was on the 5th of April, and basically what it says is that, okay, this is the top of the letter, the line, the headlining line: 20 Kruger Street, the Main Change Building, City and Suburban, Maboneng, Johannesburg. The second, the subheading is 2018 to 2020 Learnership Apprenticeship Program.
Dear applicant, we are pleased to inform you. Okay, so it says, dear applicant, we are pleased to inform you that your apprenticeship application that you applied for was successful. Please visit our office for induction, screening, and pre-agreement signing. Please read the email carefully and its requirements. Your cooperation during induction will be essential and vital.
Right.
Right.
Then it says, payment structure, monthly stipend. Successful candidates will receive a monthly stipend
of 9.6 plus transport allowance for the entire learnership duration free. Accommodation, medical aid. Requirements, please read and understand the email carefully.
As in the induction room, there will be no time for questions.
Halfway.
Take a few steps back.
You ain't got the answers, man. You ain't got the answers.
And then it says, requirements, please bring a copy of ID and matric.
Also, bring 330. This is in bold and it's in red.
Only if you do not have a police clearance report from SAPS that's older than 2 months. And ITC report from TransUnion. Please note, we do not charge any fees for the job. The 330 amount will be required to cover the cost for criminal record check, background check, and academic verification check with a reputable certification company. So they tell me that my appointment is on Saturday, the 7th of April, 2018, between 7:30 and 8:30 a.m.
Early. I got there at like 20 to 9, and there was still a line of people that were going in. So that was a lie.
And the second letter, the second page of the letter, the letterhead is 20 Kruger Street, which is the address.
Please bring the required amount above. Kind regards, Gregory, head of department. And then they put a cell phone number. Now the only problem that I had with this was that, so when I got there guys, I met like a number of people, right? When I saw these people, I realized that, oh okay, cool, I can at least like ask around like what's happening, you know what I mean? Because I mean, they got there before me. So I met this girl that was there. Okay, so basically when I got there, there was like a girl with like two guys, I think those were her brothers or something, and she was like preparing to leave. And then there was like a girl on my left. She was like sitting there, like the last one in line. So I was gonna sit on her right, like behind her. So I started like speaking to her, finding out what's been happening. You know what I mean? Like if they know the name of the company, like what's like so far, so like what's been happening. So she tells me that the receptionist lady said she doesn't know the name of that company. They've been renting at that building for about a month and they know absolutely nothing. nothing about the company. So for me, that was like red flag number one, because I was starting to think, that's kind of weird, because when the interview is held on a Saturday, where the other people, like the other companies that are in the building or that work in the building aren't there, you know, and it's just these people that you don't know of, you don't know the company of the name of the company, there's no letterhead on the letter, so you can't look for a company name. So there were just like a lot of red flags popping up and stuff. So then eventually, like, this girl goes in and they like call me in, and I'm just like, no, I'm just tripping, I'm just like uneasy, I'm just like thinking, should I go, should I not go? So I tell this guy I'm coming back. I go downstairs, I call my mom, I tell her everything. She's just like, yo mo, it's a scam, my child, it's so dodgy, because Gregory didn't have a surname. Gregory was a head of department, but we don't know which department Gregory was a head of. We don't know what company Gregory was a head of, which department in what company. And yeah, it was just very dodgy, you know. And I mean, if the company is trying to pay for my fees, like, if you're gonna give me a learnership, why would you want money from me, you know what I mean? So there were just a lot of things that were like, you know, popping up, and my instinct was just telling me that, girl, don't do it, girl, don't do it. And I went back upstairs, I took the girl's number that went in, and I took another guy's number, so that I could basically find out, like, you know, if, like, what was happening. And till today, they're still waiting for the replies. And after they paid their money, they said that, yeah, they're gonna contact them in 48 hours to tell them there is, like, if they are, like, you know, they good, like, they don't have criminal records, whatever, whatever, whatever. But that was supposed to be last Tuesday, and till today they like still waiting. The only reply they told them was that they must fill in forms, but that was it. So I just feel like, moral of the story, guys, is that we need to be very, very careful, especially with these online things. Like, you can apply for a job or like a learnership or for school thinking, you know what, I got this, God has my back. Gandhi, you're getting scammed. You take your lost money, you loan your lost, well, money that you can't even afford, because you're thinking, oh my god, I'm getting a job. But in reality, you're just getting scammed. So guys, be careful here, especially with these companies in like Johannesburg, like CBD, Maboneng, these companies that are renting like spots. It's very, very dangerous. Like, if a company doesn't have a company name, a letterhead, an email address that you can send, and it doesn't have maybe a registration number, if you can't Google the company online and it doesn't give you a SEPA registration number, guys, be very, very careful. Do not fall for the trap. But yeah, guys, nonetheless, I got out of it without getting scammed, because my instinct just told me no, and my mother told me to actually trust my instinct and my gut. So I trusted my like gut feeling, and I was just like, nah, it's not worth it. It wasn't worth it, because I was gonna be sad and dead broke that now I lost my lost money trying to, like, you know, earn a living or make a living, you know. So yeah, guys, anyway, thank you so much for tuning in. If you enjoyed this episode, please press that like button. If you want to join my YouTube family, press that subscribe button. I'd really, really appreciate those subscriptions and those likes. But more than anything, thank you very much for tuning in. Until next time, bye.